Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture on Aspen Tech channel. So this lecture is related to the Aspen Exchanger design and rating, the new software which we will be starting from today onwards. And this lecture is basically focused on the introduction of this software. So as you can see, what's new? Obviously, if you want to have view any information related to the new version of EDR, which is Aspen Exchanger design and rating, EDR, E for Exchanger, D design, and R rating, then you can click here. If you want to load the examples, different examples are available in the library of the software, you will click here. Similarly, training, models, if you want to see the events from Aspen community, you will click here. If you want to start a new simulation file, then you will click here. And if you want to open any simulation file which is already built, then you will click on open button. If you want to customize to see material database, chemical database, unit database, you can click here as well. So you can see these are the recent models which were opened, but this lecture is particularly related to the introduction of this software. So first thing is to click on this new, and you can see different options are available: shell and tube mechanical, plate and frame, plate fin, air cooled, fired heat, wound. If you want to estimate the cost, then budget cost estimation. If you want to do the mechanical design, metals and properties and tube sheet layout, so you will click on the requirement, like what is your requirement if you want to design a heat exchanger, or if you want to rate a heat exchanger, or if you want to simulate a heat exchanger, or if you want to do the some costing related to it, then you will select the suitable option accordingly. Let's select shell and tube and create the simulation file. As you can see, we have already done the simulation part in Aspen Plus as well, but that was a shortcut simulation. This is a rigorous simulation. If you remember our previous lecture, which was related to the Aspen HYSYS, we used Aspen HYSYS and linked it with Aspen Exchanger design and rating, and we had done the rigorous design. So as you can see, this is the geometry representation, calculation mode. If you want to do the designing or sizing, you will click it. If you want to do the rating simulation, or if you want to find the fouling, you will click on the suitable option. Then this is the configuration of this heat exchanger. First one, which one you want to select: A type, which is channel and removable cover, B type, C, N, D, which is the suitable option for you. You can even select it, and you can even ask Aspen software to calculate it. Then again, the E, one pass shell, two pass shell with long baffle, split flow, double split flow, and so on, kettle, cross flow, etc. Similarly, M, bonnet, removable channel with flat cover, L, N, P, S, T, so on. So these are the options which are available in its database, or you can either specify these, or even Aspen can give you the information about it. Then location of hot fluid, usually by default it is shell side. You can even vary it depending on the information available from it. Then the tube pinch, you can select the unit as per your requirement or desired. Then the tube pattern, either it is 30 degree triangular, 60, 90, 45. Then tubes are in baffle flow, yes or no, even you can select this as well. Then what is the baffle type? Single segmental, double segmental, triple segmental, you can select it as well. Then the orientation, whether it's horizontal or vertical in the system. And again, you can even select the heat exchanger material, and for carbon steel it is 1, like for SS304 it will be 6. Similarly, for SS316 it will be 8. So it will also have some impact of heat exchanger design, and similarly if you want to rate it as well. Then specify some designs for sizes for design. If you want, if you click no, it will not open. If you click yes, it will open, and you can give the design information over here as well. So this is the first part of this activity, which is geometry, but it is currently ticked. It means no information is needed. If you take it to rating or checking, it will be cross, means you have to specify the information. If it is design, then there is no need to specify anything, but if it is rating or checking, then you can see it will be crossed. Now you have to specify the process conditions of hot side and cold side in design. Currently it is in English units, US units. You can click SI from here, It is the same pattern, same procedure of changing the unit set as that of the Aspen Plus or even Aspen ICES. And you can specify the flow rates, the pressures, inlet pressure, outlet pressure, inlet temperature, outlet temperature, vapor fraction, etc. as well. And again, if you want to specify the pressure drop, the fouling resistance, you can specify over here as well. This is one way of doing it. Another way of doing it is to click on problem definition, and in headings remarks, you can click which is the company, location, service of units, and so on. This information you can fill over here. Then the application options, that the calculation mode is design, the location of outlet by default, again, it is shell side. Select geometry based on this dimension. If you want to select SI, you can select here. If you want to pick US, it is updated as well. And then the calculation method is advanced or standard. Obviously, we want always an advanced method. Then the process data, if you can see, it is the same data which was presented over here, but in a different style. Like shell side, you can even name fluid. You can give the mass flow rate, temperature, and obviously, again, the degree of freedom concept will apply over here. And how it will apply, we will see in the next lecture. But for this, you have to understand the degree of freedom is number of variables minus number of equations. So it must be zero for it to converge. Once this blue, as you can see, this is sky blue, disappears, it means the degree of freedom has been completed. So it will also give indication to you, like in Aspen ICES, it gave an indication of green. In Aspen Plus, it gave an indication of tick. And in this, this sky blue will disappear. Then in property data, you will specify the composition of the hot stream and again the composition of the cold stream. User specified options, as you can see, Aspen properties, Com Thermo, BJAC. User specified, we are usually related with the Aspen properties. That we click on Aspen properties and search from the data bank related to the composition, and then hot sites composition specification, whether you want to specify mass flow rate or molar flow rate or their percentages. It's clearly up to you. And the same is for cold stream, that you can either give the user specified properties or you can choose the Aspen one. Don't look at it right now. We will discuss at some advanced stages, but currently we will use Aspen properties to specify it. Once you have specified the process data and the compositions, you will have to simply click on run. And once after running, what you do, you have to check the performance. Like from here, you can check the performance, you can check the spec sheet, you can verify the geometry, you can review the different profiles. Like in result summary, you can see, you can even get different warnings and messages over here. Like, for example, as you know, the by default location of hot fluid is in shell side, but it could be problematic as detected by it. So you can change it over here. Similarly, if you haven't specified pressure drop, it will give you a warning. If you haven't specified the fouling resistance, it will give you a warning. Then you can see the optimization path, how optimization has been carried out, and the optimized design is selected. Then recap of designs, various designs are included, TIMA sheet, overall summary. Then hydraulic summary, performance, heat transfer, pressure drop analysis, flow analysis. So it will give you a bigger and advanced form of heat exchanger analysis, that at which points the pressure profile, the temperature profile across various points in the heat exchanger. It will give you a zone analysis. It will give you a heat exchanger geometry. Like in mechanical summary, you can see exchanger geometry, setting plan, and then calculation details. So it will give you like this information here. Let me take you to one example, solved example of this system, and then we will come back to the real-time example in our next lecture. So this is one example of shell and tube heat exchanger, and you can see at shell side it is methane, at tube side it is methane. Cold stream is at shell side, hot stream at tube side. This is a change which has been proposed by the system. Then you can see the property data, hot stream composition. You can see methane from Aspen properties, weight flow rate is 1%, and same in cold stream. And then once after clicking on this run, you will get the warning message, and there is no warning involved. There is just an advisory or notes available that the consolidated process condition for stream 1 prior to main calculation will give a heat load of this against a flow rate of this and an outlet temperature of this, and same for the second stream. The advanced calculation has converged after 18 iterations and design calculations successfully completed. Once you get this type of information, it means that the design has been okay. If you get any information in input or if you get any warning, you need to first resolve that warning before getting an acceptable design. Then you can go to this optimization path and you can see a lot of designs have been, you can see okay, near means to the given design, and okay means that the designs have been approved. And you can see that 25th number design has been selected in the process. How this has been selected, we will discuss it once we go there. Then you can see the recap of designs, the TEMA sheet in the system, which has been prepared for the heat exchanger, which you have already learned in your undergrad or graduate course. Then the sketch of the heat exchanger and the information given to it is provided over here. Then the overall summary of this system is provided by here. Then you can click on thermal, hydraulic summary, click on the performance of the heat exchanger, the heat resistance distribution, overall performance, shell by shell consideration, hot stream composition, cold stream composition. Since it's a single component, so obviously the composition won't change, and even in heat exchangers, the compositions don't change. Then really the heat exchanger profile, the heat transfer profile, the pressure drop, the flow analysis, and then mechanical summary in exchanger geometry. You can see the exchanger geometry information over here, the setting plan and the tube sheet layout. This is the setting plan of this heat exchanger. And if you want to see the cost related to this, the costs are also given over here. This is how a heat exchanger is rigorously designed in Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating. So that's all from this lecture. In the next lecture, we will solve a real-time example and we will design a heat exchanger in it. Thank you so much.